Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. In 1959, the fossilized remains of four different types of fish were discovered south of Alice Springs, Australia. The remains were in layers of marine sandstones laid down in a shallow sea about 500 million years ago. It wasn't until the late 1960s that the remains were identified as those of the earliest vertebrates. The name Arandaspis was given to the best preserved specimens. Arandaspis is today one of the better known Ordovician fishes, yet it had a rather bizarre appearance. It was a jawless fish that lived in the early Ordovician 480 to 470 million years ago. Arandaspis had a streamlined and long, deep-bodied shape. It had a single fin extending around the posterior half of the body. With no fins to help stabilize its bulk in the water, it most probably would have swum like a tadpole, rather erratically. It is not thought to have been a particularly powerful or graceful swimmer, possibly propelling itself through the water with just a series of rapid yet slightly laterally undulating or side-to-side body movements. Its lower body was covered in oblique rows of small bony scales, each of which was shaped like a cowrie shell, and decorated with pointed tubercles, giving the skin an abrasive texture. The front of Arandaspis' body was encased in a head shield, composed of two large plates of thin bone, a deep, rounded ventral underside plate, and a flatter dorsal topside plate. The lower head shield was deeper than the upper. The head shield had openings for the eyes, nostrils, and a single pair of gill apertures on either side. Deep grooves in the shield marked the position of the lateral line canals, which are the organs that fish use to sense vibrations. These head shields would have provided support for the body and protection. Arandaspis' jawless mouth was on the underside of its head, a position that indicates that it may have fed on or near the seabed. How do we know this? Due to the fact that the mouth points downwards, either scooping up small bottom-dwelling organisms or particles of organic matter that had fallen to the seafloor. Like other heterostracans, it possibly had small, movable plates inside its mouth equipped with ridges of dentine. These plates could have made up a pair of flexible lips, which would have been capable of scooping or sucking up particles of food from the mud of the seabed. With these lips, it may have been able to manipulate things. Arandaspis means Aranda shield, after the aboriginal Aranda tribe who lived near where the first discoveries were made. It was named by A. Ritchie and J. Gilbert-Tomlinson in 1977. Species include the type, which is Arandaspis prehistoricus. It is uncertain what it actually ate. It was possibly 6 inches or 15 centimeters long. It has been found in New South Wales in the Rowena Formation and in Northern Territory in the Stairway Sandstone Formation in Australia. It lived during the early to mid-Ordovician, 480 to 470 million years ago. Fossil representation includes multiple specimens. And special thank you for watching this short Prehistoric Beast program episode of Jawless Fishes. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.